Hello everyone, I hope all of you are having a good day today so far. Today I'm going to show you how to make a flower paper, because I think these days a lot of flower shops are closed and it might be hard to find a fresh flower. So I think I'm gonna show you to make yourself one. For this video, I choose a tulip flower. Actually, I really enjoy drawing a flower because I think flower has no exact form. So you can draw it whatever you like in the way that there's no right or wrong. So I hope all of you will not be afraid to draw it, and I hope you will join me to create your own flower as well. And this is my new eraser. And as you can see, the edge is pretty small, so it works really well for me. Now we're starting the second flower. You can pick up any bottle or vase and compare the size to draw your flower. Point two dots for size of your flower, and then connecting the dots and creating two more lines. Draw two more vertical lines as you're creating a box, and that box would be a size of your flower. Repeat the process for the second flower as well, and then you're going to draw a circle on the first rectangle that you made. And then you can drag a line as a cup to the end of your box. For the flower stems and leaves, I think you can draw it whatever you like. And the flower petal dots the ending point of the petals and drag it down. After you're done erasing your sketch, grab the darker pencil and do the finishing line together. I have searched some photos of the tulips earlier, and I think I'm gonna choose to color the flower in yellow, white, and purple. Thank you. Some tips for coloring the watercolor, which I learned from my university teacher, is that when you're coloring, always add a color from another part of your drawing together. And now we are done. Let's remove the paintings from the sketchbook. The next step is that we are going to cut our flower out of the paper. You can use the scissors to cut it, or you can use a cutter to cut it as well. If you are using the cutter, always use a cutting board. I have two kinds of cutter. The normal ones which we always use, but this one is quite hard to cut it as a curve. And this yellow cutter, you can grab it as you're grabbing a pencil. So it's a lot easier to move around in a line that you would like. I recommend you cut it hard, and you can cut it twice as well, but always be careful. And after we finish cutting this one, we're going to be done. It's finished. I love it now, even I'm just holding it. And after you accomplished something, give a reward for yourself too. How about you guys? Do you like your masterpiece? If you did, please add this hashtag on your pictures too. See you on the next video.